became a member of a union when I first started teaching. And at the time, I chose the union that I was going to be a member of by asking around in the school that I was in terms of who had the best reputation in terms of representation of teachers. I didn't really care about the actual union itself. It was more the personality of the union rep that I went for. Since moving into senior leadership, I have generally moved towards the associations that reflect the senior leaders. So I first joined the NAHT, but then left a few years later, as it seemed to have a much more primary focus, and then I joined the ACSL, which had a much more secondary focus. What do I get out of it, and the reason that I do it, is more for advice and support and help, really, from an association that you hope will understand the reasons you are in the job and the reason you are asking questions. So, for example, from the ACSL, I receive a magazine periodically, which has lots of reasonably relevant information and research in regards to leadership and management. If there are issues that I need to talk about in terms of my own career or questions in regards to issues with members of staff or students or parents, I just feel that the ACSL are much more connected to the kinds of things that I'm going to ask and therefore the advice that I'm going to need. So in the upshot, the main reason that I joined the union in the first place was for support, and I have to say that the reason why I'm still a member of the union now is exactly the same, it's all for support. And having that bit of knowledge that someone there externally to your organisation can support you if you need to.